At a time when the world was mired in poverty and disorder, the Pepys brothers were devising ways to get success in a yet unknown new world. The two would go on to establish their unique skills and make profound achievements in their respective fields of medicine and literature. A few years later, the two joined the Brotherhood of Hecate in London, a group active at the time in the realms of positivism and research into natural phenomena. However, the true and hidden pursuit of the Brotherhood was unholy research towards the creation of the ultimate human being. These depraved experiments led to the creation of mutant beasts and the spread of disease and chaos throughout London. And in the fateful year of 1666, Samuel Pepys, who foresaw the impending doom, set fire to the underground laboratory in the hope of wiping out every trace of the Brotherhood of Hecate and its evil research. In a matter of minutes, the fire spread throughout London, and the whole city was engulfed in flames. It seemed that all had perished into the ashes, save one. Now, Daniel Pepys, aware of his brother's suspicious acts, murders Samuel, and together with the gruesome records, disappears into the darkness of history. Ignatius, a priest in the Church of England and a specialist in mysticism, learns of a frightening increase in the number of missing clergy, as well as sightings of inexplicable monsters. Unable to obtain any facts or solid information, Ignatius one day receives an ancient and mysterious book from out of nowhere. Written on the cover of the tattered volume is Samuel Pepys and nothing else. In deciphering the contents, he learns of the mysterious Brotherhood of Hecate. Realizing the seriousness of what is before him, he quickly sends the book to his mentor in the United States, Professor Jean, and requests a detailed assessment. Professor Jean and his daughter Nadia begin their research based on this diary of Samuel Pepys. As fate would have it, however, Professor Jean is soon found murdered at his hotel. During his last moments, Jean has found the strength to leave a single message. He works alone, his hands defiling the bodies of the dead in his thirst for knowledge and power. His name is Adam Crowley, a man who was once respected in the field of science until fate led him along another path towards black magic. Now he is in possession of the mythical Lost Diary of Samuel Pepys, a volume that contains the detestable rituals of the demon-worshipping Brotherhood of Hecate. Soon, he will complete his work. Tonight, as the sun sets on London one last time, he will unleash his demonic brood onto the streets. And should no one stop him, this city will be consumed by a horde of nightmare creatures.
Oh, Thank you. Thank you. You Thank you. Blood. Oh! Thank you. Oh! Thank you. Thank you. Ha 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 ha!